Hello, a very good morning all of you. I'm Ms.Taniya Sutradhar and today I'm going to cover the topic singular and plural nouns. But before we come to that, let us first recapitulate what a noun is. A noun is a word for a person, place, thing or an object. All these things are called nouns. As you can see in this very classroom that there are so many nouns around you. A bottle, a book, keys. Then you have newspaper, registers and bags. These are all called nouns. Now, we are going to categorize them into singular and plural. Now, how many newspapers am I holding in my hand? One. So, it will come under your singular noun. Let us look at some other object. How many bottles are there on the table? Two. So, it is more than one. Then it will come under your plural noun. Now remember this, students, when there will be more than one object, it will come under your plural nouns. Let's look at some other objects. How many bags are there? Oh, there are more than one. There are two bags. So it will come under your plural nouns. Now let's look at the books. You can see that there are more than one book in this class. So this will come under your plural nouns. Now let's shift outside the class. You can see that there are so many. Now I'm going to show you how to make this singular nouns into plural nouns. For this, there's a set of rules that we need to follow. And I'm going to show you a very interesting video now. Hope this video will help you to understand the concept in a better way.
Nouns, singular and plural. A noun can refer to one or more than one person, animal, place or thing. A noun that names one person, animal, place or thing is called a singular noun. For example, a boy, a cat, a house, a flower. A noun that names more than one person, animal, place, or thing is called a plural noun. For example, boys, cats, houses, flowers. We add s to most of the nouns to show plural form. We add es to nouns that end in ch, sh, o, s, double s, x and z to get their plural forms. For example, ostrich, ostriches, dish, dishes, mango, mangoes, bus, buses, princess, princesses, fox, foxes, quiz, quizzes. Sometimes, some words ending in O take only S in its plural form. For example, piano, pianos. Look, the plural of ox is oxen, not oxes. The nouns that end in a consonant followed by y change into plural form by changing the y to I and then adding es. For example, city, cities, country, countries. Hey! don't drop the Y from monkey. The plural of monkey is not monkeys. It is monkeys. Just add S at the end.
The nouns that end in a vowel followed by Y change into plural form simply by addition of S. For example, key, keys. To form the plural of a noun that ends in F or FE, we replace the F or FE with VES. For example, leaf, leaves. A few words do not follow the rule. For example,
chef, chefs.
Some nouns have the same form in singular and plural. For example, sheep, hare, deer, bison. Nouns that do not form plurals in the usual way are called irregular nouns. A few singular nouns form their plural by changing the inside vowel or vowels. For example, man, men, tooth, teeth.
Helpful to you? Well, I don't know about you all, but this entire exercise just made me hungry. So why don't we all have some pizzas? Yes, students, I have planned out an interesting activity for you all where you can make pizzas at home. For this, you need an A4 size colored sheet. Just cut it into a shape of a slice of a pizza. Make some pepperonis using different shades of colored sheet and just write few singular nouns on them. Like I have written baby, so the plural of baby will be babies. And as you all know now that the plural of sheep will be sheep.